This is a 2012 Ford Explorer, 3.5 liter V6. We're going to be changing the spark plugs out. And to start out, make sure you keep your keys well away from the car so it doesn't start on you. Once the hood is up, you want to take off this cover right here. And there's two screws that you got to take care of. One right back here. Try and get a little more light on. One right there. That just screws out. And one right here is a pin. You just put a screwdriver in there, pop that center pin up, and the whole thing pops right out. You just get your screwdriver in there, pop up that one, see? And the whole thing comes right off. Screw that. Now you just want to work this out around, just like that, and this comes off. And now you have access to the engine. Next you want to take off this vent, because this entire plenum is going to come off. So you've got this spring right here, this gray pin, like that, just push it, compress, and it pulls right off. You can tuck that down. Mass airflow sensor. Underneath is a little slider. Just get your fingernail underneath there. It pulls back, and then you want to push up and pull straight back. Here, I'll show you. There's the pin, the slider that goes back, and then you're pushing right here to pull that out. Right here, 5/16, 8 millimeter. Bolt, loosen that up, then rotate like that. Same in the back. This one's probably hasn't been messed with since the truck was built, so it might be a little bit tougher. Take a little more off, and that's loose. Next, you want to release. This plenum off of here, which just pulls right off. Try not to pry on the mass airflow sensor. And then this is gonna pull off here. You've also got this one airline right here that's gonna have to come off. So you just pinch that with pliers. Push that back. And this will come right off. Be careful, this is just a plastic nub. Once you get this vacuum line off, push that off to the side. That is one vacuum line that's on the back of this piece right here. That's all connected. Just leave that connected up to the side. You got this electrical connector that's going to have to come off, as well as this electrical connector. Same as the mass airflow sensor, basically. You gotta pull that pin out and then compress. There you go. You gotta come back a bit. Okay, so you got this electrical connector off up here. You've got this connector off here. You also wanna get this purge line here, those two green tab, squeeze, and that pops over like that, and then off it comes. And now you want to start getting all these bolts. So you got one up top, side. Now this top bolt will pull right out. Just get that out of the way, because you don't want to lose that. The rest of these bolts are all captured, so they're in to stay. So just leave those along. There's one more bolt way in the back, and you got to get down in here. Once that bolt is out, it's tough to see, right there, holds onto this wiring loom right here. Once you pop that out, all your electrical connectors, your vacuum lines, and those bolts are out. The Plenum will just pull right out. Nice and straight and go easy. Don't forget, if you haven't done it yet, make sure you take some compressed air and blow the engine off. Get any dirt and grit out before you take this Plenum off. Once it's off, get some rags, stuff them in the holes, and we'll move on to the spark plugs. Okay, now that your manifold is off, you want to do your spark plugs. I recommend you do them one at a time. We'll demonstrate the first plug on the front, just because it's easier to see. But basically, I just started here by taking off this electrical connector. And with this electrical connector, I'll show you right here. Take a screwdriver on this red tab, and you want to push back all the way, okay? And then you're gonna use your thumb, push in. Make sure the tab's all the way back, by the way. Wasn't back enough. Push, pull that out. So that's disconnected. Got your 8 millimeter bolt that's gonna come out. Here it is right here. It is not captured, so don't drop it. Pull it out. And then this is your coil. This should just pull right out. Take a look at it. Make sure there's no cracking. Look inside, make sure it looks good, and keep it off to the side. Don't drop it. That's a super expensive part. And you're gonna see down into the engine here is the spark plug. Hit that with a little bit of air real quick. Get anything out of there. Make sure there's nothing in there. And you just use your spark plug wrench to pull that out. And we'll take a look at the plug. So we got the plug out, and as you can see, it's having a tough time focusing. No oil, a little bit of rust on because they put these in dry, but that's okay. But it's nice and clean, with no soot or oil or any concerns. One thing I'd recommend is on your extension, because it's so far down into the engine, get a locking extension so that you don't lose your spark plug wrench down in the engine. Now you're just gonna take that, once that plug's out, you inspect it. A little air down there, make sure you get anything out. Take your new plug. If you want to put a tiny bit of anti-seize on, you can, but you don't have to. Drop that down in. And on your coil, you want to put a little dab of silicone. Okay, so all your spark plugs are replaced. Your coil packs are back. Your electrical connectors are on. Spark plugs are done at this point. Now, while you're here, look on the back of the engine right here. That's the PCV valve. You might as well replace that while you're at it, because you gotta take the Plenum out in order to access it. Take your channel locks, grab on. Rotate till you get past that lock. You just pull it right out. See how nasty that is? Pop a new one right in its place. Only cost you a few dollars. Now we're ready to put on our Plenum. Okay, so now we got the Plenum upside down. We got to get the old gasket out because you're not supposed to reuse it. So just get a screwdriver, a little pick to pull up one corner. And then work it out. Put that to the side. Clean this up. You gotta clean it up with a little brake cleaner if you want. Hit it with some air, dry it off. There's a new gasket, just presses right in place. All right, so there's the gasket in place, the new gasket. Make sure you push down on this good. There's a little bit of a, like a catch feel as you press that in, because you got all these little fingers here that grab in. I don't know if you can see those. You just want to make sure you can press that in, because you don't want this thing popping off when you turn this upside down to put it back on the engine. At this point, we're ready to install this and reverse our procedure. Place this right on top of the engine. Make sure you pull out your rags you got in the intakes. Bolt it down, reconnect it.